What's going on, everybody? It's JamCon TV. It's your host, Pun. We're going to do a... going to be streaming late today. Appreciate you guys taking a listen. I'm thinking about... we're going to stream... Of course, I'm going to do some StarCraft as a warm-up. And I'm thinking about doing Watch Dogs tonight. It's a new game. It's not new. It's new for me. Watch Dogs 2 is on its way out. For those of you who haven't played 1 like myself, might actually run that. So we'll see. Let me get the word out here. Yeah, man, slowly but surely we're getting closer and closer to the halfway point to the convention. Very exciting stuff. Oh man, hit that follow button, guys. Tuning in on Twitch TV, hit the follow button on Twitch so that way you can get notified when the stream goes live. This is, of course, a live show. And if you don't catch it live, you can also catch us on YouTube, youtube.com/C/JamCon. Let's get let's do this one. So definitely catch us there. If you haven't already, again, go to www.jamcon.com. Get your tickets, your discount tickets, $25 for the weekend. Get you the latest on all of the convention information. We have the JamCon app that's going to be coming in a few months also. Also hit us up on Twitter, at The Real JamCon. And we got the podcast, soundcloud.com/JamCon-podcast. So we're all over the place on the social media tips. So just, you know, facebook.com/JamCon. We also have the JamCon Facebook group, the public group, JamCon Versus. So definitely hit us up there. And we got a mirror matchup for the first matchup. We've been teetering from top 5 to top 10 on the platinum ladder. So we're hoping to get a little bit more consistent on the wins. That way we can finally get to the Diamond League. That's the goal. Quest the Diamond. I was in the Diamond League just before Legacy of the Void came out. Had finally made Diamond League. I didn't play as much then, so I wasn't really learning a lot. I do want to start watching the replays and really breaking the game down. I'm going to get serious about getting to the next level. I plan on doing posting the coaching session that I'm going to have with Des Rowe. So stay tuned for that. I've been doing this 2 gateway opening. Kind of flirting with it a little bit. It's probably a better way to do it. I go gateway. 2 gateways. They pretty much get all my infrastructure up and then I expand. That's basically what happens. by the time this builds, we have the whole base saturated. It's always a good look. Okay, got those two started. Let me get our first two. Get these out, that's first and foremost. Then we'll get the expansion. Pylon down. Lost his mothership core. For the reckoning. I'm here. Oh no, didn't bring him back. Yeah, I didn't scout. Thank you. What is up with the lag? Yeah, scouting on my end was horrible on that. A pylon should never be in my base. So I've got the little things. And he used to be Grandmaster back in 2011. Little things cost games. And that game really should have been mine. Hate losing just simple stuff. Him not having that pylon, he's pretty much, I wouldn't necessarily say dead, but it's not a close game. Gotta handle the little things. Gotta handle the little stuff. Timings. I need to attack at 6 minutes and probably 12 minutes. I need to really pay attention to when the attacks come. Not losing a lot of points on these losses, which is good. It basically means I'm not just getting my hat handed to me. Scout early. Good pylon placement where I've got my whole base, have areas of my base covered, with a little sneaky crap like that can't happen. And there was some lag there too, which did help the situation out. Didn't seem like it. I would press stuff and it would be very delayed. Lurkers, man, they're just Lurkers are so ridiculous, man. All it takes is a handful of them. That's all it takes. I've got to be a little bit more aggressive against Zerg. I mean, truthfully, if I was Zerg, that's all I'd do. That's all I would do. Let's just go straight up Lurkers. Another Zerg, good. Same guy. Same guy, different map. So we gotta go crazy aggressive with this dude. No, I'm not gonna even do that. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to play the Stargate. Thank you. Woo, boy, that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. I couldn't talk on that one, but he, one mistake. That's what I'm talking about. We got to watch that one. So, woo, that was good. That was a good one. Let's watch the replay. Let's watch the replay. Now, one thing that helped me out again. Okay, so let's watch from his perspective. So Zerg is tough because, again, the lurker is a beast. So they can get the lurker out pretty quick. And the lurker, once it burrows, it's invisible. Well, you know, it can't be, you need detection to see it. They have a wide range of attack on their spikes. And they can pretty much melt your army for a toss. Stalkers, Zealots, they melt them. Immortals are the only things that can kind of, you know, take some hits. Gotta have upgrades. I mean, it's just a lot. And then when you have the Lurker, Hydralis, their Lurker, Hydralis army with the with their Overseers, which, so what happens is the Overseers, they detect my Observers. The Hydralis automatically shoot for the Observers, which then kills my detection for the Lurkers. So you can see how that's a problem. So basically, you know, I just played this guy. He beat me, and he beat me on the first game that we played, the second minute. Well, you know, before this last one. And you know, I just, so this time what I decided to do, I opened up quicker on the Stargate, and I wanted to harass. So that was the big thing. I wanted to harass with the air, keep him kind of on his toes. And while doing that, I wanted to practice getting my macro better. So while I got him occupied, the key is while I got him occupied to be building my army up back at home, getting upgrades, things of that nature. And one of the things that saved me was I was +3 on attack. So I was maxed out on my attack. And I think I was +1 during, but I think by the time the last battle was over, I was +2. This works well for immortals and things. And so in any event, let's go to 6 minutes. Now right now I'll just push them back with the attack. He's got speedlings. I know if I go further, I'm gonna get caught out there, so I'm not worried about busting in. We're gonna shift in right about here. Okay, I'm already pressuring. All right, weakening these queens. Queens are key units. If you can kill a couple of queens, that hurts their larva injects pretty bad. But again, at 6 minutes. Now, right at the 6 minute mark, let's see. You know, and I want to analyze. I'm talking about. I'm going to analyze it. So he's got 45 drones. I've got 40. Okay, so not too bad. He's got 9 Zerglings, which these 5 Zealots can take care of. I got four Phoenixes on the field. He's got 3 Roaches. So, you know, I've got some sentries for defense in case he tries to do a counter. But right now, I'm trying to make use of these Phoenixes. So at the 6 minute mark, that's where we're at. He's building up larva. You know, so now if we, again, I'm still coming in here. Hold on, so I've taken out a couple of queens. I'm taking out, I didn't even take that out. That's a mistake on my part. I mean, he's got all these dudes. Yeah, see, I've got to search around and take care of these dudes. But nevertheless, so we got our first engagement here. Lost a Phoenix. That's why I wasn't quick enough. Lost a Phoenix. But here at this point, if you look over my bass, I'm working on, I'm already working on plus two. So this is gonna play a nice little part. I'm working on plus two. So he's pushing at this point. He's pushing. Now again, these Phoenixes are gonna come in handy because they're gonna help me live. They're gonna help me defend. I can kind of go from defense to attack. So he's gonna come in. I've got my immortals. Let's see what I got here. We got one immortal, got 11 zealots. I've got six Phoenix. When we start getting to the six and seven Phoenixes, they can do some damage. All right, so at the 8 minute mark, that's where I'm at. I'm also almost on plus two. Not too bad. So anyway, I chase them off. Here come the lurkers. So I come in real quick. I already take a couple of them. He had to cancel all those lurkers. That's a good move on my end. And I chase him back. And now one thing, my money is getting really high because I'm trying to macro and fight. My money gets really high. Now, if I was doing this the way I wanted to do it, I would have been spending this money. So this is hurting me. But again, I'm up 51. Now he just built a quick six, but I'm up. I'm on 51 drones. I got my third started. All right, but he's massing. He's massing. The lurkers are in play with plus one. I've got plus two. Working on plus three. So I'm still keeping the upgrades. And I realize I don't have enough gates. So the gateway explosion had to happen. But I got a decent army. Plus two. I can do some damage. But anyway, here he comes. And this is a problem. But again, I've got my Phoenixes. I've got eight Phoenixes. These, putting them to use, it's a great thing. And all I have to do is be patient. I just have to be patient. This doesn't look like a big army, but again, they're plus two, working on plus three. I got three immortals in the mix. I see him trying to come around, which I'm cool with, because again, I push these guys back and I can, I'm dishing out hits and then I lift the lurkers. That was key. Because my army really could take care of these dudes. Now I try to go all in, but see, I messed up on the micro. I messed up there. And again, he's starting to get upgrades. He's plus one. All right, so we're still even on drones. I got three bases, but see, my base, it's not saturated yet, So he's look, boom, he's already re-upped. And I need more Phoenixes. I lost a lot of Phoenixes on that. I've just got to get better on that end. Now here come the lurkers, plus two lurkers. Now we're at the 12 minute mark for the third attack. Let's see where I'm at. I've got plus three. So, we're maxed out on attack, which is excellent. But he's gonna take this base. Now at the same time down here, I said, okay, you know what? I'm not pressuring his main base. That's a problem. He clearly's got to have a fourth by now. So I'm like, okay, let me build the zealots. I got some stuff back here. Might have to get this one up. But I got some stuff back here to possibly defend. I'm also going, he's going Hydralis Templar. The storm really melts those and it'll help me against the lurkers. But this is a plus three zealot attack. His whole army is over here. Big army at that. But his whole army is over here. So he readies up. I'm like, okay. Now, when you look at this area, just by the way, look at this area that they cover. So I'm like, okay, let me go in, see what I can do. Can't do much. Let me just move. Now, as I'm doing that, there's nothing he can do about this fourth. So we basically trade. I said, okay, let me just defend up here. I sent my my dudes down here. Of course, he knew it. That's why he knew I was down there. But anyway, I'm just, there's nothing he can do about these zealots. These plus three zealots, nothing he can do. Nothing he can do. So not only have I taken the second out, I mean, it's fourth out. I've stopped him at his third. So this brings his whole army back. Now, I should have expanded. In hindsight, I didn't see this guy. Expanding here would have been great. It eventually helped me win the game, but getting the Templars. We're at the 13-minute mark. Templars done. I've got five Templars in the army, which is big. So this is going to allow me to keep them back. Okay, again, I'm up on drones right now, even though, I mean, I'm only mining off of basically 1.5 base, but so is he. Not a lot of money coming in. We're still pretty even on supply. Again, I'm working on plus one, I believe. Yeah, almost done with plus one. So let's get back to him. So this is, I mean, it's an economic game at this point. I'm not knowing if I'm going to really, you know, win this or not. It's an economic game. He sees me building down here. There's so much going on. I didn't even see this dude. I'm right up under him. Didn't even see him. But it worked in my favor because he basically brought this whole army. Again, when you're talking about Templars, it melts these guys, especially plus three melts. So I go and catch him off guard. And then I pull back. I took out a lurker. So it's all about being patient. He's got 30 of these dudes. But it's all about being patient. I did get a lurker. Let's see how many lurkers he got. He got four lurkers in this army. He's plus two. I think at this point I'm three. Plus three. Yeah, I'm plus three, plus one. Templars have the armor. Okay. So, he comes in, one way in, one way out. I go on ahead and warp a couple of cats in. And this is just to really occupy him. Now, look how quick the zealots melt. They melt quick. But see, at this point, I bring my dude, he's looking for the rent. Now look, I got him in there. He's in here. Yeah, he's gonna take out a whole bunch of my. He's getting more. Now that was one of his mistakes. I didn't realize that. He got a ton of lurkers. But the thing is, all I gotta do is chill out, because in order for him to move out, he's gotta unburrow the lurkers and move out. He knocked me down to 44, but again, now I had the presence of mind with this. I started building a couple of more zealots with the little money that I had. I do have my third building before I did anything. I want to get the third building. Now, here's key area here. His money, he's basically out of money. All right. He does have two bases up and running. He's got 50 drones to my 42. I've got a third coming, but right now it's one base, two base. Okay, supplies are pretty similar, but again, my army composition, I got nine Templar. Okay, I built a ton of Templar because it's really all I can do. I've got three observers, so here we go. See, now my zealots catch these guys. I mean, we're talking about plus three zealots. They're only plus one. They're gonna melt, and I got armor, so they're gonna melt off the rip. Now we got the plus two, plus one, but here I'm keeping them at bay. He moves them out. They take storm. I mean, they eat. Look at that. Eat the storm. Look how quick a couple of storms just melts his army. Now, at that point, he tried to move out with just the Hydralisk. And like, again, Templar, you know, they roast the Hydralisk if they just stay in that storm. He's got lurkers left. All I got to do is stay out of their range. But the guy really doesn't, and there he is, right there. He really doesn't have any money. There's not a whole lot he can do. Boom, I'm just keeping him back. When you want to move back up, boom, more storms. And they just stay, he burrows them right there. And at that point, there's not enough lurkers. I mean, we're talking about plus three immortals. All right. So, at that point, the lurkers are gone. He's got five Hydralisks left. I mean, now at this point, He's got no army. He's got 6 Zerglings. He's got more drones. But I've got an army. I've got 5 Immortals. I still got all my Templar. I got killed. I don't know where or when, but they got killed. I'm left with 1, but I got the Phoenixes left. I got to get 5 Immortals, 4 Zealots. More importantly, I've got a ton of money and gas. I've got a third that is basically would be done, and I can ship over, you know, almost 10, you know, well over 10 probes to saturate that immediately. He just doesn't have an army. He doesn't have the money to get an army, no gas. He doesn't have time, because I'm coming for him. I'm coming for him at that point, but he's out of time. That was a good win, though. That was a good win. But yeah, opening up with Stargate and then just, you know, trying to keep up with upgrades, keep up the pressure. Notice what he's getting. Typically, they go in Lurker. Got to get the Immortals. You got to get the beefy units that can kind of take hits. Get the Templars. I could have done a lot better, though. I mean, I was 130. That's the highest I've ever been. I've added my APM has went up a few points. The highest I've ever been. An APM 130. All right, mirror matchup on Frost. Let's see what we can do. I lost on a match I should have won on Frost. I'm gonna spread those pylons out a little bit better to get a visual coverage. Again, I appreciate you watching the stream. Hit that follow button and be notified when the stream goes live. Also, subscribe on our Twitter or subscribe on the YouTube page. This is where all of the live streams are going to be uploaded to. So it's youtube.com/C/JamCon. Definitely appreciate that. Better go on scout and see what this dude is. Also, we're on Twitter, twitter.com/@TheRealJamCon. So definitely hit us up there. All right, let's get the first. Awesome. Paranoid. Dang it. Base. Messed that up. I need to have. Well, I should have scouted. I didn't know he had immortals, so I should have scouted it. But I should have put two pylons down there. Gotta have two. You win a hard match and then you get beat by some easy miss. Please let me get him again. I promise I won't lose to that nonsense. Taren, I hate this map. I gotta get rid of this map. This map is horrible. Come on. Gotta get the expansion. Base is saturated. just stretching me thin. Gonna win this one. I don't have enough gates. Thank you. He's got 3-3. Yeah, I could have had him. Upgrades killed me. He was upgrading the whole time. That's one thing. Gotta upgrade. Alright, let's try another. Thank you. level.
Thank you.
It's those mind drops, man. Those mind drops are freaking killing me. That or I'm just getting tired. Hold on 1 second. Yeah, I got to play a lot safer. Those mind drops are just killing me. And then he took, there's so much I did wrong with that one. Frustrating. Oh, I've got to remind myself to get rid of this map. Thank you. guess again, that map, let me veto that map while I'm thinking about it. Because that map, so what he did was he blocked off, both entrances were blocked off. So let me veto that one. Let me get another, see what else kind of nonsense map. See, let's veto that one too. Yeah, he blocked off both maps, both areas. He went straight Muta. Yeah, he went straight Muta. Let's see if he can break the losing streak. Stream this long, but played this game this long. Oh, wow, so we build our stamina up. But we did end it with a win. I wonder what APM is still up there. It's good. That was a tough one. Oh, he used to be Team Masters. Wow. A few years ago, of course. All right, people. That concludes. We pretty much StarCrafted out tonight. Got a couple of hours in. And I'm going to go ahead and call it for the day. But again, I appreciate you guys watching the streams, GemCon TV. We might get up early in the morning to do some streaming, play something, get something different, maybe do Watch Dog day one and see what's going on there. Again, follow us at our all of our social media sites, man. Facebook, we're on Facebook, facebook.com/JamCon. We have the members page, JamCon Versus. We have hit us up on Twitter at The Real JamCon. Get your discount tickets for the convention April 21st through the 23rd, 2017, at JamCon.com. Hit the follow button on Twitch to keep up with us when we go. When we go live. Also subscribe to the YouTube page. We want to try to get up to at least 20 subscribers by the end of the month. We're at 6 so far, so definitely support the stream there, and we will see you guys next time.